Hi guys, and welcome to Cultnomics. My name is Paul Hanley, and today I'm going to be chatting to you about
the concept of inflation. In this video, we're going to look at the concept of inflation and how price rises can affect the economy and how to measure same. So we'll start off with a basic concept of price level, which is a measure of the prices of goods and services in an economy at a particular time. So what we can see is that over time, an awful lot of prices increase for goods and services. And this increase in prices is inflation. So it's an increase in the general price level or a reduction in the value of money. So if we start off with a 50 euro note, but the money supply increases in the economy, well, an increase in money supply tends to erode the value of money. So more supply of anything tends to erode the value of it. So in this case here, what can happen is if you were a saver, for example, and you save your money wisely for the future, inflation can actually eat away at the value of this money. And we can summarize this idea with a little equation, which is money all divided by the price in an economy. So as prices go up in the economy, the value of your money, the value of your take-home pay in some cases, decreases if you're not getting a wage increase. So the inflation rate then is generally how we measure it. That's the change in the price level from one period to the next, normally presented in percentage terms. And we measure this in general in the economy. This inflation rate comes off the consumer price index, the CPI. That's a measure of the overall price of goods and services bought by a typical customer. So what do we mean by a typical customer? Well, it's a market basket of an average household. So the average household goes out and spends, for example, on groceries, they spend on transportation, they spend on beverages, on health, on education, a whole range of goods and services that are purchased. We can measure these through a survey called the Household Budget Survey. And we can look here at the weights of this household budget survey. So how do we weight the importance of things? Food and non-alcoholic beverages are 11% of people's spend, clothing and footwear 5%, health 3%, transport 14%, etc. So they're given weightings and we can compile this CPI. The body then that's tasked with controlling the inflation rate and money supply is the central bank. They have certain targets out there, and a lot of central banks generally have a 2% or roughly 2% inflation target. So why would you want any inflation in a country if it reduces the value for money or it increases the cost of living? Well, two extra concepts that we need to understand that is disinflation, which is a reduction in the rate of inflation from one period to the next, and deflation, which is a fall in the general level of prices. So if prices are actually falling, people put off spending. So if people put off spending, it tends to reduce the spending in the economy. It also tends to lead to debt levels increasing in real terms, and which can hinder expenditure in the economy. So inflation comes with a number of advantages. These advantages would comprise mainly of, number one, with inflation in the economy, it generally tends to encourage spending because you'll buy something before it's gone up in price. So it encourages that spending. It provides room for monetary policy expansion. If the natural interest rate is too low, well, then inflation allows the central bank to decrease the real interest rate. Three, it aids wage adjustment and market clearing. It's very hard to decrease the actual wage rate of a worker, but maybe you can increase it by less than inflation, which is a relative wage decrease. It also reduces the real value of debt, so it means that you're paying back money and it's worth less if you have a loan. And it triggers production through greater spending, so if it's enticing expenditure, it's increasing production levels as well to match that.
I hope you call back to Cultnomics soon. Bye for now.